Hey everybody, welcome to another edition of The Freak Show. I am your Ringmaster, Jeffrey, and we are here at Game Daily Connect, and it is an incredible day. EsportsCircus.com sponsors our show, The Freak Show. We are proud to be here at the Game Daily Connect conference here in Anaheim, California, at the beautiful Disneyland Hotel, where every day is magic. Because you have to be full with magic. To have, you have to wish people a magical day, right?
Every single time.
And speaking of magic, speaking of all that stuff, I was walking by all the game booths and I saw a really incredible booth. I'm an old D&Der from way, way back in the day, and I saw these really cool dice. These dice freaked me out. I love these dice. They're very cool. D20, all that stuff. D4, D8, D12. These guys had it on, and they brought their game, their A game, no pun intended. And so I stopped by their thing and played their little game. It's kind of like a card game. I'm also a big Magic Gathering guy, so I was impressed. I like anything with cards.
Yep.
So I have my friend from Preston. Why don't you tell us about your game?
Aloris is a swipe your own adventure game.
Swipe your own adventure game. So
yeah.
The game can develop in any way you want, right?
Any way you want. And it's all procedural too. So every decision that you make in the game is completely tracked.
Uh-huh.
So it's kind of this really, really amazing experience where you get to set off on a new adventure every time.
Okay.
Start as a different backstory every time. And often get a whole different experience each time you get to play it.
That's right, and you have different characters, right?
And there's like a bunch of different characters that you can do, and the backstories are really what make it interesting.
Yeah.
Because those give you a whole new perspective on the world, because you get a new entry point.
Right.
With every new backstory, you know, if you're the cook, maybe you enter the world having just burnt a cake for the king.
Oh.
And now there's this whole thing that unfolds where you get mistaken and you're brought into a dinner party, or, you know, let's say that you're the barbarian starting off. And if you're the barbarian, then perhaps you're sent on a quest to save your people's homeland.
Okay.
So you get this really, really cool different experience every time you get to play it, but it still very much harkens back to that single-player D&D sensation.
Yeah.
That's kind of what we're trying to accomplish.
That's very, very cool. And D&D is going on an insurgence now with Stranger Things. Stranger Things came out. Everyone's playing D&D again.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy, the renaissance of D&D that we're getting to experience now. It's
yeah.
really exciting for us to be able to see.
That's very sure. cool. So how long have you been developing this game?
So this game is actually a pretty short development cycle, and I think that's because, you know, our focus has been on accessibility and simplicity.
Mm-hmm.
And when you kind of, you limit yourself design-wise in that way, you end up creating something that's very narrowly good. So our entire development cycle so far has been about 5.5-6 months.
Wow.
And that's because we've just been so brutal on ourselves about making sure that, like, anybody can show up and play it. You can swipe left and swipe right. And that's the simplicity of our design process and also the simplicity of the game.
Okay. Did you do any outside development, like India, for graphics or animation?
If only. No, we didn't do any of that kind of stuff.
Uh-huh. It's all in-house.
We got to work with a few developers in the States.
Okay.
But mostly just LA folks. Like
LA folks, great.
Yeah, Stephen Liu is a really amazing composer based out of LA.
Yeah.
He did all the audio for the game. But yeah, it's mostly just the three brothers, Ray, Will, and I.
Wow, that's great. And so what do you want to do with the game? Where do you want to take it? Do you want to sell it to, is it going to be on Steam?
Yeah, so it's coming out to Steam, iOS, Android, and Xbox, as well as the Discord store, later September probably.
Okay.
We're saying late summer.
Uh-huh.
So coming very, very, very soon.
Okay. And what's the name of the game again?
Aloris.
Aloris. So check out Aloris.
Yeah.
And all the things. So what is your end game what is your end game?
We want people to play our game and like
it.
That's the end game.
Is this your first game?
No, we've been a studio for 5 years now.
Okay.
So we had Snailians VR was our very first game. It was a cute little tower defense shooter for virtual reality.
Okay.
Since then we've done a lot of contract development work with a bunch of different other studios. Cool to be part of a lot of bigger projects. And this is kind of getting out from under a lot of those studios, our first project that we wanted to make something simple, that was all our own, that we could be very, very proud of. And that ended up being Aloris.
That's very cool. Well, congratulations on that. Check it out, Aloris. Check it out, it'll be on Steam and iOS and Android shortly. Check it out end of September, November maybe, something like that. But keep your eye out looking for it. And if you have any questions, please contact us at Esports Circus. At 800-287-5095, that's 800 287-5095 will get you hooked up with all the people that we saw at the show, here at this incredible gaming conference for developers. And we'll see you guys later. Thanks for joining us here on another edition of The Freak Show. And I'm Jeff Stansfield, your ringmaster and host.